The armed forces of the Philippines say they are looking into reports the Abu Sayyaf group has deployed a second van containing explosives similar to Tuesday's fatal Basilan blast. The military refused to give further details, but said operations are now ongoing against so-called persons of interest to quell another possible attack.
All possibilities, all indicators that would suggest and would relate to that particular incident, lahat tinitignan natin yan just to ensure na hindi nga maulit.
The AFP said the bomb that exploded and killed 10 people in Lamitan is easy to manufacture by the terror group's remaining bomb experts. The military also says the bomb's materials can be bought in hardware stores.
May mga tao pa sila, even yung mga sumuko nagsasabi na meron pa silang, kumbaga may mga na-trained na andyan pa.
Kung may suspicious amount, large volume of these components are being purchased over the counter sa mga hardware stores, then they are not prevented from selling. But then again, they must inform the security sectors.
But the Interior Department said a potential terror attack may be prevented if members of the community will be more vigilant. Anyo also believes the Basilan blast has nothing to do with the passage of the Bangsamoro Organic Law. Anyo said initial information showed the bomber may have been targeting the Nutrition Month event in Lamitan City, where some 4,000 students were expected to participate. But on ANC's early edition Friday, a security analyst warns the country may see similar attacks if the proposed shift to federalism is handled poorly.
So I think it would be very difficult to prevent attacks like this. And creating different layers of a state or a federal kind of system would only complicate coordination, and it would only possibly dilute resources. Federalism handled badly would only exacerbate local insecurity, would only exacerbate local politically motivated conflict.
Franco also does not believe the Basilan blast is a case of suicide bombing. Authorities also add claims that a foreigner carried out the attack remain inconclusive. But they add they are aware that the Abu Sayyaf group pledged its allegiance to the Islamic State. Malacañang also urged the public to avoid speculating about the Basilan blast after the Islamic State claimed responsibility for the incident.
I still have to get a final investigation report from law enforcement agencies. We are still not verifying that this was an ISIS attack. Authorities are still investigating. It's very easy to claim credit for an attack.
Ron Gagalac, ABS-CBN News, Zamboanga.